मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, नमस्ते। हाउ आर यू? होप यू आर कीपिंग वेल विथ योर हेल्थ एंड स्टडीज। ऑनलाइन टीचिंग इज बीइंग गिवन टू यू एंड आई होप यू आर एंजॉयिंग एंड डेडिकेटिंग योरसेल्फ टू द फैक्ट्स एंड आइडियाज सप्लाइड टू यू प्रोवाइडेड टू यू थ्रू ऑनलाइन। यू विल वेरी सीरियस एंड वेरी सिंसियर टू योर स्टडीज, योर ऑनलाइन स्टडीज। Always be very attentive whatever given to you. Keep your pen, paper ready and write down, note down the important things after watching the video or after seeing the note. In course of this teaching through online, today I am going to give you something very important from practice book, grammar, and that is the tense. The most important part of grammar, tense. Sometimes it is very confusing for the people, for the students particularly. What is the difference between time and tense? What is time and what is tense? It is very clear that tense is the form of the verb which also shows time of action. Tense is the form of verb which also shows the time of action. What is here? Tense, the form of the verb which also shows time of action. Okay, and what is time? Time is the meaning of verb. Time is the meaning of verb. For example, if I say I am going to teach you, I am going to teach you after some time. If in this sentence, if I ask you what tense am I speaking, your answer is, sir, you are speaking in present tense. I am going to teach you after some time. But if you are asked to tell me what time am I teaching you, then your answer is, this is future time, because I have not started. After some time I will start teaching. Likewise, if I say he is coming tomorrow, tense is coming, the present tense, but time is future, because the person has not come yet. He is to come tomorrow, future. So I think it is very clear that what is tense and what is time. Now you know well that there are only two types of tenses, present and past. You may be surprised, sir had not spoken about future. Yes, because future is not tense, future is time. The time and tense together makes three forms. Present, past and future. Present and past tense and present, past, future time. In time 3, present, past, future, but tense 2, present, past. Now, the subkinds of tenses, you see here, 12 subkinds of tenses and time. 12, indefinite, continuous, perfect. Indefinite 3, continuous 6, perfect 3. Total 12 subkinds of tenses and time consist of 3 indefinite, 3 indefinite, 6 continuous and 3 perfect. How? Present indefinite, past indefinite, future indefinite. Continuous 6, present continuous, present perfect continuous, past continuous, past perfect continuous, future perfect continuous. Perfect 3, present perfect, past perfect, future perfect. So you have your 12 subkinds of tenses. Now, as you know well, that tense and time both are based on verb. So here you see, in any indefinite, not particularly present indefinite verb first form or S form, go goes. Past indefinite verb second form, went. Future indefinite, shall will go. It is very clear. Go goes, went, shall will go. In any continuous, it is very easy. In any continuous, you will always put verb ing form. And in any perfect, you will always put verb third form. Okay? Now you will be given some elaborate description about the sub kinds of tenses. Present indefinite, how can you know it? There are some adverbs that are generally used in present indefinite. Always, usually, often, rarely, generally, frequently, sometimes, every day, every night, every week, once, twice, thrice. These are the adverbs generally used in present indefinite. Present continuous, now, at present, still. These are the words. These days, nowadays, these are the words used in present continuous. Present perfect, ever, never, just now, already, recently, yet, till today, till now. These are the words used in present perfect. Present perfect continuous, it is very simple to understand. For, since, after, for, since, you will get time. For, since, time, that will be present perfect continuous. Past indefinite, yesterday, ago, last day, last night, last week, last month, last year. These are the words used in past indefinite. Past continuous generally connected with past indefinite with some conjunction. As, while, when, as, why. Again, past perfect, again connected with past perfect, is always connected with past indefinite. And you can know by looking at the conjunction before, after, sometimes, when also. Past perfect continuous, here you see, it will be always connected with past indefinite. And you can know that after, for, since, time, there will be time. So, for, since, the and time, it is for two tenses, present perfect continuous and past perfect continuous. Difference is that past perfect continuous will take past indefinite too. Then future indefinite, tomorrow, next day, next week, next month, next year, in the coming days, coming week, this is future indefinite. Future continuous, till tomorrow, till today, till next day, till next month, till next year. And then future perfect, again here you will see the conjunction before, after, but before future perfect, and after, before present indefinite. After, before present indefinite, and after future perfect. Matlab, future perfect plus present indefinite, second, present indefinite plus future perfect. Okay? I will be given some questions and you will practice at home.